When buying or selling your home, call Leo Bato. He has years of experience in real estate, showing honesty and integrity in every transaction. He's a person you can definitely trust. So book your appointment with Leo Bato today by giving him a call at 818-648-4837 or by visiting him on the web at www.leobato.realtor.
And the podcast will begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, Eugene, and of course, Medwin of True Faith.
Hey, Paco. Woo!
Hello, everybody.
Hey, Paco, thanks for having us.
Ang nakakatawa rito, this was supposed to be a virtual episode, diba?
During the pandemic, yes. There was like a couple attempts to...
Tapos, yeah. Noong na-solidify namin ni Andy, shout out nga pala kay Andy Barce, noong na-solidify namin ni Andy na natuloy ang True Faith sa OPM Summerfest, sabi namin ni Michael Abad, wala nang virtual. Kasi pag nasa Pilipinas ka, doon na kami pumapayag na pwede mag-virtual . But when you're in North America, walang virtual. You really have to be at Paco's place. So thank you for being here.
No, thank you for having us here in the States. It's because of you and attitude, si Mark and si Jonathan. Thanks for having us here. Yes, and we're here in North America. That's why we have to be here live.
Yes!
Live in the flesh and
okay.
Wonderful studio, man.
So now, thank you. We had a show, the first show for OPM Summerfest. Did it exceed your expectation, or was it what you expected, or did it fall short of your expectation? Start with Eugene.
Oh, yun. Beyond. Way beyond our
expectations. Bakit? Bakit?
Kasi, pag nag-tour kami, di ba, di ba nakwentuhan tayo last night, yung expectation ng mga, yung anticipation ng mga tao was really high. Grabe. Yung balang yung nag-usap kami ni Mark about yung tickets, ganun kabilis ang bentahan ng tickets. Uy, bilis ha? Kasi you know, we're used to playing in smaller venues than last night.
Yes.
Diba? Pag nag-tour. Kasi mga naman ang mga Filipinos, hindi naman.
Mga sa, 200, 300.
Yes, ganun. Tapos, nung tinitingnan ko, yung mga venues, diba?
1,500, 2,000.
We were still in the Philippines kasi nga pinapromote. So, ginugoogle ko yung mga ano. Ang lalaki nito. Kaya ba to? Pero yun, sabi ko sa'yo, the genius was you put the festival word.
The festival word.
Word, di ba? Dahil...
Naging inclusive lahat. Yes.
And uso kasi mga festivals.
Right.
Di ba? You have Burning Man, Glastonbury. Uso . Kaya nung nakita ko, so okay.
Coachella.
Lollapalooza, di ba? So yung dahil linagay mo yung festival... Naging, piyesta to. Sa atin, piyesta tawag dyan . Piyesta tawag dyan. So, yun na nga, nung nakita ko anticipation. Tapos, nagulat pa ako lalo.
Okay.
Nung pagtugtog.
Hindi, huwag muna pagtugtog. Okay, rehearsal muna.
Rehearsal.
Yeah. Kasi, guys, kami ni Eugene, pagdating sa mga parts ng True Faith, kaming dalawa yung siya yung musical director ng True Faith. So, kami yung...
MD raw.
Hindi, dahil ikaw nagkukumpas sa amin ni na JJ, ni na Nathan, ni na Vic, di ba? So, I'm sure yung stress mo na para may show ba ang True Faith sa... What was going through your head?
Hindi, sa akin lang, yung, dahil nagpa-practice tayo, ako kailangan... Ayusin natin tugtog. Huwag kami mapapahiya. Di ba? So, yun ang abuti na. Magaling to. Magaling to.
Tayong lahat.
Pero aside from that, di ba? Syempre, naninibago sa palo.
Of course.
Yung mga drum rolls mo na iba-iba. Yes. So, pero, galing. Sabi ko, galing. Diba? When we were backstage.
Well, shout out sa mga drummers ng True Faith dahil talagang ni-research ko lahat ng mga drummers na dumating. Ni-YouTube ko lahat yun para lang to get the essence nga.
Yeah. Galing. And we pulled it off, man. Yeah.
Yung going to your question.
Did you, di ba yung, okay, alam mo may sinabi na ni Andy sa inyo, okay, mayroon tayo OPM Summerfest kasama ng River Maya, Intro Voice, Glock 9, What was did did after last night's performance, yeah. Did we exceed your expectation? Did we fall short, or was it it was not what I expected?
Yeah. Alam kong very successful mangyayari. It was a it was like a really dynamite lineup. So alam kong maraming taong pupunta, alam ko na sobrang masaya mangyayari. Napaka-eclectic ng lineup, iba-ibang flavors. So yeah. I'm sure it's gonna cater to a lot of people, it's gonna attract a lot of people, and truly so it happened. I knew it was gonna be so energetic. I knew it was gonna be so powerful yung interaction ng people and ng artist, ng tayo. But I didn't know that it was gonna be that crazy. It was
exceeded your expectations.
Yeah,
actually,
it was freaking crazy. It was amazing. It was really amazing. Parang yung ganung lineup, yung ganung packaging, yung ganung production. I knew it would constitute some reactions, some semblance of ano, parang ganung labas, no? Ganung labas. Pero it was like major, super bigger than what I expected. So it was really amazing. So
good.
And you guys made it happen.
You were amazing. As in last night, talagang nung July 16, 2022, you just strutted on that stage and talagang pinatibok mo lahat ng puso nila, no? Talagang
are we talking about Soler?
No.
Oh, we're good. I'm going ahead of you.
Kakapon.
Kakapon ko lang ako. July din ata yung susuli.
July,
Let's not talk about that.
Well, we can.
But I brought it up. But yun sobrang...
I think we should.
Nagtawanan sila because that's when I almost fucked up our story.
No, you can say that.
Our Solaire show.
It's an effort.
Yeah. Jonathan would have slapped me in my head. Nothing would have happened. So sobrang talagang iba yung
feeling.
I knew there was gonna be a really successful show. I knew there was gonna be a lot of energy.
Magic, no?
I knew there was gonna be a lot of electricity, but Kagabe was like, oh my god, it was like different. It was on a different level. Yun lang yun.
Having Nathan Azarcon playing bass, Vic Carpio, JJ Buencamino, yun.
Such an honor.
What a weird combination. First time lang din mangyari yun.
Hindi weird yun. It's bound to happen.
It's talagang magic eh. Grabe.
Bound to happen, yeah. I've known JJ. I've known si Vic for a long time. I know they're such amazing musicians.
And Nathan and me go way back.
Diba?
Yeah, they go way back. And you playing on drums, such an honor. And it was amazing. It was magical. So yeah. Thank you. Thank you for that, for backing us up, man.
Thank you.
And thank you for being patient and all that.
Sobra. You mentioned magkakilala tayo already for a very long time.
Since the 90s.
Why did you start a band?
Bro, I told you many times, right? That music compilation that Intervoice was in, 10 of Another Kind, that was such a pivotal moment in my life. I mean, I've had my musical heroes. I listened to the Beatles. Beatles made me want to be a singer, made me want to be an artist. Duran Duran made me want to go on stage and do what he did on the video of Reflex.
Pero
it was like the dawn and that album, 10 of Another Kind, which you guys were in.
Yeah.
Just a Dream and yung song na kinanta ni Jobert.
Lalabay.
Oh my God. Sana kinanta kagabihan. If he was here.
If he was here.
I love it. So I know.
Jobert!
I know.
Shout out.
So, The Dawn and 10 of Another Kind was like, parang yun yung nagsabi sa akin. What those Westerners, yung idols mo, did can happen here locally because these guys, you know, you guys, Intervoice, were part of that. You can do it here and make great music and then, you know, make it big. And, you know, entrance a huge population, a huge part of the population, you know, make songs famous, make OPM famous. So man, you're an inspiration.
Thank you. So nung sinanong naisip mo yun, when you had that epiphany na, you know what, I wanna be in a band.
Yeah.
Binulungan mo ba si Eugene na, I wanna be in a band? Or did you keep it to yourself that you wanted to be in a band? Or kasi magkaiba ang journey nyo eh.
Yeah.
Later na lang kayo nakita sa music eh.
Ang original na kabanda ko is our older brother, si Eldwin.
Okay.
Me and Eldwin were in a band called Strictly Confidential.
I know that.
Yes,
band. Yeah.
Yes, and we had some demos played sa 99.5 RT, right. At sa NU107. Yes. NU107 back then was new. So we had some songs there. Tapos we joined this annual band contest sa Lasal.
Okay.
It was called Amplified Ambitions.
Alam ko yan.
Yes. 1988, sumali kami. Previously, 1987, After Image was the grand winner.
They won. Yeah.
Yes. And that's how I met Wensi and I knew Wensi because he was the winner dun sa 87. Yep. 88, nag-third place kami ni Utol. Strictly Confidential name na band. Ang corny ng name. So, you know how corny it is kasi kunyari, what's the name of your band?
Strictly Confidential.
Okay, batang suplado. Batang sabihin ng name. Okay. But anyway, corny. Okay. Anyway, after that,
Strictly Confidential.
Because of one of the songs of Strictly Confidential was recorded sa Fullerton.
Yeah.
That's when I met si Octavio Arisal.
Yes. Hindi ko alam nyo to. Siya kaya ng isa sa mga head ng Vivid Entertainment.
Ano yung Vivid, bro?
I-Google nyo na lang.
ang alam ko, wait. Si Octavio Arisal, ha? Siya yung kasi nag-rec, bro, ha? Nung recorded one of the songs ng Strictly Confidential sa Fullerton, which was owned by Tommy Tanchaco, who was your original manager.
Yep.
That's how we connected, yeah. Right? So, si Octavio kasi was there. So, Octavio was the engineer. And then he said to me, hey, you know what? You can sound like this guy and this guy and this guy. Do you want to sing for Multiplex Tapes?
Yun na.
Oh, yun, di ba?
Yeah, yun na yung racket.
To sing for recorded...
Ano ba ang Multiplex?
Hindi nakakalam na Multiplex.
Ang Multiplex ay isang...
Mga sinaunang minus karaoke, di ba?
Ang complicated yun eh. Mas complicated pa sa Google. Paano ba sabihin?
Try it.
No, anyway, earliest versions of the karaoke.
Oh, yeah. Video kick. Karaoke. Tas there was this machine
that played cassette tapes.
Oh, God. It's complicated already.
All right.
I'm sweating. Okay.
So you have a cassette tape and you pan the... There's left and right because it's stereo, right?
Yes.
It's stereo yan sa audience. Alam mo naman pa kasi ito.
Okay, explain.
It's stereo, right? So there's the left...
Pa-explain mo sa kanila, Jay.
There's the left speaker and there's the right speaker. There's the left and right sound.
Yeah.
So pag yung multiplex, yung early version ng ano yan eh, karaoke.
Yeah.
So, yung boses, nasa left lang. Yeah. Right, yeah. Nasa right, left. Ang boses nasa left.
Okay, you've lost the audience already.
Oi.
You know what? Never mind. Google it. Okay, anyway. Para gano. Cut the story short. So, this is guy, si Octavio. So, he heard me sing and then sabi niya, you can do the multiplex tapes and all that. And that's when I did the jobs Fullerton.
Yeah.
That's when I met you guys.
Kasi palagi tayo nakikita ron.
Yes.
Eh,
and then si Tommy, he managed you guys and you were right already at the cusp of your stardom.
Right.
As in sobra, when the first album came out, si Ira pa,
yep,
band member nyo. And then you all from LaSalle and already we're hearing, oh my God, have you heard of Intervoice? They're such a fucking great band, you know, in LaSalle. You know, so naririnig ko na kayo. And then yung lahat ng student people, they're student body, yeah, they were amazed by you. And I'm like, no, I see them often sa recording studio.
Oh, yeah. Doon din. Yeah, sa Fullerton.
Bro, going back to Octavio Arisal, did you know that he was an engineer for one of the REM albums?
Yes.
Yung reveal.
Yes.
One time, bro, sa 2000 ata yun. I kasi I'm an REM fan. I bought an album of REM. Pucha, nakita ko sa
sleeve.
Sa sleeve. Nakalagay doon, engineer Octavio Arisal. Parang, putang ina, kasama ko. Putang ina, can we connect? You know,
Andito siya.
Talaga, tangina talaga. Tara, let's connect.
Yeah.
Because he's with Vivid. I'm so there. I'm so there, man.
San? Siya ang nag-bix ng Breaking New Ground.
Yes! Oh, there you go!
Yeah.
There you go! That's how we came together. Ano nga ba yung question mo?
Hindi. Paano nagsimula ang True Faith? Then,
yun! Diba? Tapos, si Ferdy, nagsumali
rest
din.
Rest in peace.
Sumali, yes, rest in peace. God bless the guy. Sumali din siya sa Fullerton. So, Ferdy and I were part of Strictly Confidential. Strictly Confidential this
Teka, part. Sino nagpasok kay Ferdy sa Fullerton? Ikaw?
Parang I tried to, you know, try to ipasok siya.
Para mag-engineer?
I don't know what happened. Parang hindi ata natuloy. Kasi mag-graduate pa na nga ata siya sa, ano, sa school. Sa, saan ba siya? Sa,
Eng siya yata. Di ba?
Hindi na, mass com siya.
Lyceum yata. Lyceum. Letter V yun.
Bro. Lyceum. Pero nakapasok siya doon and we were like workmates. And then, that's where I met si Francis Guevara. And then
sina Acer, sina Karel.
Yes. And then si Acer and Karel. And then during those times na nagre-record ako, bro, nakagawa kami ng kanta yung perfect nga.
Sino talaga gumawa ng perfect?
Si
Oh, teka. Ano yun?
May phone in question tayo. May phone in question
phone
tayo.
Phone in. Jonathan Brent can be the phone in.
Yes, sir.
Teka, sandali. Oh, sandali. Jonathan off mic. Oh, ito off mic.
Hindi,
off mic si Jonathan. Okay. Okay, Jonathan Brent can be the phone in.
Ano, na-remember mo ba na ano na tinanong kita that time na pwede ko ba mahingi yung perfect?
Alam mo yun?
Oo, di ba? Yeah, I did.
Oh my fucking lord!
We knew na mag-hit yung kantang yun.
Oh, that was JJ naman. Okay. Diba naman na dyan, Jay? Oh my God.
That would have been interesting in Intro Voice. You still could do a version of perfect in Intro Voice.
Pero mangyayari, kung nahingi ni Jonathan yung perfect, wala kayo rito ngayon.
Buti na lang, say yes. So,
wala na ako.
Yun nga, bro. So we did...
So, sino nagsulat ng perfect?
Si Kiko at saka ako. Tapos,
anong storya ng perfect?
Tandaan
mo, ha?
Secret!
Sinabi niya, kasama yun sa pag-uusapan, di ba?
Sabi sa'yo, walang sex life. May sex, pero walang sex life.
O may sex life bang involve yung perfect?
Hindi, love life.
Yun lang, romantic life, pwede pag-usapan.
Romantic life, pwede pag-usapan. Without...
Ergo.
Paco, alam mo naman okay, na di na dapat na pag-usapan
yun. So anyway...
In 2 years. In 2 years.
Did you know?
Oy, bro, pag nandito na ako.
Sige. Asahan namin yan. So ito lang tanong. Did you know that Perfect was going to be the perfect song to launch True Faith? Totong sagot, ha?
Alam mo, bro. Lahat naman tayo, we've been through things, you know, we don't expect. Like Intro Voice, you know, when you got the band together, parang you had hopes, you have dreams,
right.
You have aspirations,
right.
You have ideals, you want the songs to be like this, you want your dreams to be like this. You have images of yourself on stage playing and girls going crazy while you're playing. You have all of those, but you know, it can go this way or it can go that way. It can happen or it cannot happen.
Pero,
parang ganun din. When Perfect, when we did Perfect, I thought it was like a special song, you know? And I think
okay, so you knew it was special.
Yeah, I think it was a good song. And then, eto nga bro eh. Kasi, eto mamaya, pupunta ko kay Tommy kasi I really want to publicly say thank you to Tommy kasi we, ano yun eh, parang stealthily,
we didn't
tell him that we were recording.
Kaya nga, hindi namin, we were on tour.
We were using electricity and recording
studio
and tape. I know. You know what? One time nga nag-Itbulaga guesting kami with Barbie, and Barbie's managed by Tommy. I told Barbie one time, pakisabi kay Tommy Barbie ha, na, we are so greatly in that. All these years I never actually got the chance to say thank you.
Alaga, sisigiling ka with interest.
Anyway, so when we recorded that, you know, secretly dun sa studio, I didn't know it's gonna be big. But plano ko talaga kasi
this episode is brought to you by Leo Bato and Associates, ang realtor na pato.
Either NU or ano RT. Pero sabi ko mas bagay sa 99.5 yeah. RT. Sabi ko
doon din nilaunch ang next in line, ha.
I know. Oh. Alam mo, et bro, ito nga eh, yung trajectory ng careers natin ni Wensi yeah. Yeah. At saka kayo.
Yeah.
Parehas eh. Kasi even
I know.
At saka there was a time na RT 99.5 RT went alternative
yeah.
And they were playing White Roses
yes.
Ninyo.
Yes.
They were playing your songs. They were playing Just a Dream.
Yep.
Yun na nga eh. So, parehas tayo talaga ng trajectory. Kasi even Next in Line was a
launch
hit.
There.
Was
yeah.
a hit on, yeah. on RT. So, we had a Canadian tour nga kami ni Wins. We were like, alam mo ba, RT ka? Although, we're rock and then we're
like
identified with NU. Pero ano, it was actually 99.5 RT that was playing a lot of After Image songs, lalo right. na Next in Line. Anyway, bro, so going back to what you said, I wasn't really expecting, but I had hopes. So, noong 1992, inantay namin matapos yung elections na nanalo si FVR.
Yes.
Noong nanalo si FVR, sabi ko, okay, tapos na yung gulo sa mga media, sa mga politics and all that. I actually went to RT myself, and then si North Andrew.
Okay.
You know
North
Andrew?
Yeah.
Just God. He's such,
Kaling, you know?
I think he's like one of the best DJs talaga, radio yes. DJs ever. I went there and he was there and was like, can I leave this song?
Tape.
Tape, diba? Can I leave this song here and then if you fancy it, can you play it? Bro, they played it agad, nag top 40 agad sa kanila. And then nag number 2 and then yun, nag number 1 and all that.
So like, sinong label ang pumikap?
Octords, bro.
Okay.
Kayo, anong label ba kayo?
Polycosmic.
Polycosmic. Yeah. Polycosmic's like Police right now.
Yeah,
na?
Police.
Okay. Actually, ang back catalog ng True Fate is...
EMI.
Yes. Yes, Police.
Yes.
Police.
Yes. Police.
So, label mates tayo, bro.
Yeah.
So, yung ano nyo... Wait. Question about ano about rights and all that. Yung mga yung breaking higher ground,
breaking new grounds.
Is it in Poly East pa rin ngayon?
Yung publishing, pero
publishing, yeah, that's right.
Subject to ano namin? Kami before Jonathan.
So yung labanin, yeah?
No. Before Jonathan left for
Poly Cosmic, watch out.
Yeah. Before Jonathan left for the States, ano? Kinausap nila sina Evelyn Ciale and naayos nila yon.
Amin yun.
Bro, sinong lawyer nyo? Pahiram naman.
Wala, maganda. Shout out kay Tommy.
Hindi kami
nag-perpetual. Wala kaming perpetual.
Oh,
na, ano.
good.
So we own the rights to. So ngayon,
kailangan vinyl na yan.
Kumikita ang Poly sa amin, pero verbal. Naka-verbal kami ngayon. Ha?
Oh, okay.
If we decide to call Polly and say,
grabe yung technical, we just lost the audience. Ganyan technical tayo.
No, eh, pag pinull out.
Hindi, this is good.
No, this is good for young artists. Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. If you're a young artist, never say
the
perpetual. Yeah, like...
Explain perpetual.
Yeah, perpetual.
It's a school in Las Piñas and Piñan.
Yes. Please don't do perpetual because we just did again Viva 4 years ago.
Which is, okay, Vincent. Kanila na yun.
I know, but it's Viva. Okay lang yun.
Okay, ito tanong ko. You kay Eugene ko itatanong to.
Okay. I've been talking too much. Yeah.
No. Bakit kayo nag-label at hindi nila mag-DIY in the age of Spotify
and
iTunes?
Kasi yung mga type namin, parang kailangan naka-hitch sa ano pa rin. Sanay kami na naka-hitch kami sa ano. Tamad kami.
Okay.
Naka-hitch kami sa label. Kasi
sinabi mo si Andy tamad.
Hindi tamad si Andy. Hindi tamad si Andy. It's more like na parang nasanay kami sa ganun eh.
Yes.
Na naka-hitch kami sa label na system. Kasi mga bata ngayon, parang si ano, si shout out sa banda nung anak ni Andy, Mellow Fellow.
Okay.
Mellow Fellow.
Ang Mellow Fellow DIY.
Nakausap ko si Polo. Parang wala siyang aggregator. Aggregators.
Yeah,
Wala siya. He does everything on his own. So, hindi siya sumama. Aggregator, by the way, if you want your song to be played on Spotify. On Spotify, on YouTube, and they'll collect the royalties for you. Wala siya. Solo niya. Siya mismo. So parang, ang trabaho. Ang tanda na namin, tamad na kami.
Magagagawa na lang kayo ng kanta. Mas maganda.
Yeah, yeah. And ililimit mo lang yung, like, for example, the past few contracts namin, it's more like one album, 1 year. Ganun na lang.
Oh, pero kanila na yung kanta, yun naman sa Maro.
Sold our souls.
No. Yung 2018 album namin, Sentimental, which is available sa vinyl,
you know,
Backspacer Records.
Not promote.
Backspacer Records.
Bakit hindi?
Ano yun? Distribution lang si Star, si ABS-CBN.
Okay. Atin na yung rights.
Amin yung rights, pero sa kanila yung distribution.
Hindi, Paco, actually, yung the reason why we signed up, nag-star kami nung 2014 for distribution, tapos ngayon naman nag-viva kami. Kasi,
yung clout
nila. Ito bro, kasi sa ngayon, parang ang hirap mag-promote ng single sa Pilipinas. Ang hirap talaga.
May payola pa rin, no?
We don't
feeling
know.
Ko meron eh. Feeling meron pa rin. Pero kasi, one of the things kasi para, one of the best avenues for your music to be, para maka-reach ng bigger audience, is really through ano, when it's used in a big movie,
so
teleserye. Kasi, we had an experience. When dahil ikaw na kinover 2006. Namin, 2006. In 2006 was it? Yeah. Noong 2006 when we recorded that, it was a big hit. Tapos yung, ano pa na, yung benta pa sa amin ng Polis was like, oh, you gotta do this teleserye song because, you know, it did good for Sugar Free. And we're like, okay. Tapos when we did it, nakita namin yung results, you know? And it did great things for Sugar Free, it did great things for us. That was even with Up Dharma Down.
Shamrock even.
That was
border.
Yeah, yung Mulawin. Lalo yung Tatana, yung Up Dharma Down. That's a pretty song. When it came out, it was such a pretty song. But it wasn't getting traction because it was a poor single. It was a beautiful song. Pero dahil ginamit sa isang teleserye, ginamit sa pelikula, ganun. Kaya that's the reason why we tied. Oh my God, am I bearing my soul too much?
No.
Baka sabihin ng Viva, you freaking losers.
Normal yun eh. As artists, we have to speak out. Ito yung platform natin eh. Kaya nga may Paco's Place.
To be fair with us and them, that's what they said. You know what? We could use your songs for...
Exactly.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah, I mean, it pays na you tie yourself up with the big guys.
Right. Yes.
Sila yung big guys.
At saka, diba? Bro, so, maganda sa visa yon. Maganda sa visa. May kontrata ka sa visa. Diba, Andy?
Legit.
Yeah.
Nakita, Eugene Marfil, may letterhead ng Viva, di ba?
Yes.
Eugene Marfil has an existing contract with Viva as an artist and has an existing contract with Viva Records. Tapos nakonto notaryo pa yun.
Mark. Yun isa sa mga documents actually nilagay namin sa Visa. May parang ng Viva na we're artists. Yeah.
Existing contract.
Yeah, they're gonna hunt us down if we don't fulfill it. Jump on.
Okay. Ang true faith, lagi namin sinasabi, ang longevity nyo has a lot to do with you guys not operating on a Goldilocks template.
Sala sa lamig, sala sa inyo.
Nahuli ko ba?
Goldilocks. Kuma.
So tama tayo, Jonathan, di ba? Kasi sabi na, ang hirap ng pressure yung tatawagin kang the number one band in the land. Tapos parang, kakatampucha, anong sunod dito?
You guys had that crown.
Diba?
You guys had that crown.
Yung pressure nun sa aming lahat, nag-aaway kami internally dahil
there
doon.
You go.
Bro, kaming True Fate, original nga eh, we didn't have that crown, nag-aaway-aaway na kami. Parang we were like, the fifth best band.
Number five, yeah!
Nung 90s nga eh, hindi pala the best. The fifth The fifth known band in the Philippines. Nag-away-away pa kami. Paano pa kaya kayo? Do you know what I'm saying? I get the pressure.
Pero yeah. Sino ang kaninong template yung kaninong discarte? You know what? Let's just go Goldilocks. Yung tipong, yeah. Hayaan natin sila magtaas, baba, taas, mag-crush sila, bala sila, pero tayo, dire-diretso
tayo. Bro, ang galing mo. Actually, hindi intentional yun. Because siguro yung mga...
Kasi wala yung pressure sa inyo eh, di ba?
Wala na.
Nasa amin nasa Eraserheads, nasa ganun.
Yeah. Nung 1990s kasi, medyo naramdaman din namin yun.
Of course,
kasi we were, yes, of course. Kasi we were signed up with a label.
Yeah.
And can you believe it? We released our debut in 93. The second album was 94. The third album was 95. Every year, diba? Parang Backstreet Boys, diba? Every year. hindi pala Backstreet Boys, bro. One Direction, every year.
Pero alam mo, may hit.
Kailangan, kumbaga sa amin, may pressure. At the same time, bro, I could feel yung mga, may mga comparisons.
Yes.
Na parang, you should do something like however which way. You should do something. I will survive like intro voice. Or sasabihin naman ng producer, no. You should do something like Pareko. You should rock out more like Parvokya. Parang it was so crazy. It was so crazy na parang you had so much, so many voices, so many inputs coming in na parang, damn, I mean, lalo na, bro, I think it's one of the reasons why the original lineup broke up. Kasi after the third album, although the third album went platinum agad. Yeah. Kasi, it was a given.
Momentum nandiyan na yun eh.
Nandiyan na momentum. Pero, yeah, after Alaala, it was like, parang okay, we didn't have strong singles after that.
It didn't go bad. It just didn't measure up to the previous album.
Yeah, but
expectation mo. Yeah. Malaki.
Yeah, after Alaala kasi the singles were not as strong. So the pressure was there. I tell you, Paco, it's like parang usapan naming band. I was like, what are we gonna do next?
Tapos ikaw ang chief songwriter.
Lyricist. Tapos si Kiko and si Ferdy talaga. Kaming tatlo talaga yung triumvirate na
nag-aaway-away kayong tatlo.
Oo, bro. As in, nag-isip ko na ganito dapat. And no one was agreeing to what was gonna happen next. So, apart from the personal stuff na medyo nagsiseeping through, that's turning sour, pati yung creativity na gano'n na parang, oh my God, because that's so much pressure. There was so much pressure. And can you imagine that? And it's like, parang, we were like the lead band. I mean, you guys were like the lead band. You were like Intervoice, you know.
Hinihingan kami ng label, di ba?
Yeah, Intervoice, at saka Eraserheads, and Rivermind. You were like, mas tugatog kayo. And then, I can imagine that the pressure sa amin was already paramount. Can you imagine with you guys, na tipong your label's probably expecting another breaking
news. Pero alam mo kung ano pumapasok sa isip ko na, hindi ako nagbibiro, pumapasok sa isip ko na, I bet you, pag may bandang magdi-disband, ang true fate tumatawa.
Kami noong disband.
Lahat tumatawa. Lahat na banda.
Like, kasi kayo pinaka-consistent. Yun ang tingin ko talaga sa'yo. Pinag-usapan namin yan.
Kami owner this band eh. Original.
Yung original. But then again, sinabi ko kanina kay Mark Escueta, ikaw, si Jonathan Buencamino, at si Mark Escueta, lahat kami na wala kami sa band eh.
For a time, yeah.
Kayo lang ang hindi na wala sa banda. You're Medwin Marfil. Yeah. That's Jonathan Buencamino. You could have walked away like Wency Corneo and Bamboo and Ellie and just started your careers.
Yeah.
Bakit hindi nyo ginawa?
Internal yan. Internal yan, di ba? You were supposed to start yourself. Dapat mag-upisa ka ng sarili mo. Pero wag na, baka hindi ko alam yung... Kasi may disclosure yata yun. Something.
No, wala naman. Wala naman disclosure.
Di ba? Sa ano, non-disclosure? Is it a law thing?
No, nothing. I can say shit.
So bakit?
Ganito kasi yun, bro.
Yung name pinagawayan eh.
Kasi yung name, di ba? A lot of people think of me as a bad guy after that, yung hiwalayan. I never publicly disclosed na yung what happened talaga that time. Kasi bro, yung original lineup namin, painom, cheers muna nga tayo.
Cheers.
No. For a long time, I was perceived as a bad guy. It probably lingered. Probably.
Na parang inano mo sila, sinipa mo silang lahat
ng dating, di ba? Yes, yes. Diba? At saka parang binuwa ko yung pangalan. Hindi totoo yun, hindi totoo. Hindi totoo po yun. Kasi ganito yung Paco.
By the way, excuse me. Princess Punsalan was on the podcast na.
Okay.
So para Ate Helen tayo, di ba?
Alright. Hello, Princess.
Okay, go.
So kasi, bro, nung nag-away-away kasi yung ano, pangit-pangit.
Yung original lineup.
Lineup. And then magdi-disband kami. Tapos, magdi-disband kami and then ang usapan namin is no one's gonna use the name True Faith, right? No one's gonna use the name True Faith. Tapos, kami, it was like 3-3. Ang kakampi ko is Bimbo, the bass player, at saka si June Dison.
Yeah, si June. Shout out si June. Tagal ko na din nakikita.
Shout out, June!
I don't know if people are gonna see this. They might, you know, they might think na I'm
the bad guy still.
Yeah, because yeah, the bad guy still. Because it might, you know, it might get trigger things, you know. But I just want to set the record straight.
Yeah, set the record straight.
Only in Paco's place.
Yeah. Okay.
Exclusive.
Set it straight.
Yeah.
Inamin na bigla na ni Medwin ang True Faith ang dahilan.
Nung in-expection, walang permit.
Mike Enriquez, is that you?
Walang permit. Sino linoloko nyo?
Hindi, so balik nito bro. Usapan talaga, walang mag, ano, walang mag gagamit ng True Faith.
Yeah.
Tapos, di yun na. I was dead set on forming a different band talaga. New band. Ako at saka si June and Bimbo.
But June is strictly confidential. So yeah, I know June. Si June is a drummer.
June, no?
Yeah.
So, the other three na kalaban. Okay, kalaban. Kalaban at time. Kalaban.
That's a strong word.
So, si Kiko, si Ferdy at saka si Acer.
Okay. No, si Kiko, si Glock 9 at saka si...
Si Kiko.
Nag-aalo-halo na tayo.
Tain na, lasing na tayo. Salamat, Mike Abad, sa Nika.
Nag-aalo-halo na yung ano natin.
Okay. Salamat
so
sa tama.
Anyway,
at least hindi mali.
Yeah. So, so nangyari bro, napalitan namin na mini-meeting nila ng kabila. Of course, they're denying it. But I actually confirmed it again. It's good na makakaaway ko na naman sila dito.
Hindi.
They had a meeting. Kinuha nila si ano makakala.
No names.
Okay. Basta ang ganito nangyari, parang they secretly, no not secretly, eventually they wanted to continue True Faith without me.
Ah, mali yun.
Which is labag sa usapan.
Yes, mali.
And I can talk to June again, the drummer. I can talk to him and ask him if it's true. And I think he's gonna say it's true. Na talagang they're minute sila na itutuloy. At the time, kasi minanage kami ni Kuledesma.
Kuledesma,
oh yeah. Had her manager. So si Ku and her manager said, Wag mong payagan yan. Who named the band sabi ni Ku at saka naman ng Trofit nung lawyer Kropek nung lawyer sabi I named it kasi I was inspired by the New Order song.
I christened the band.
Tapos sabi niya, you own it. Sabi nung ano. And that started the intellectual property thing.
Good to know.
And that was like the 1990s. No one knew so much about the IPO. You know? I might have triggered something good.
you may have because importante yun.
Yes.
Alam mo si Heaven. Heaven went by the name 317. Okay. So gumawa siya ng campaign sa SoundCloud, sa YouTube, lahat-lahat until one entity IPO'd 317 and he got a cease and desist letter.
Wow.
Oh. Wow.
So natigil.
Sa amin naman, may nag-squat sa introvoice.com.
What? Tapos, diba, what?
Yung
hinakaw.
Hinakaw yung introvoice.com.
Gumawa siya. Inunahan.
So sinisingil kami ng $35,000 to reclaim the name.
Kinidnap yung .com.
Here sa America.
Sa America. So, buti na lang. Kung sa kami nakatira ni Jonathan, it was only like 2 blocks away from the ICANN, I-C-A-N-N office. Okay. Sila yung police ng internet.
Okay.
Sa tama-tama, nag-a-apply siya ng green card.
This episode is brought to you by ABA E-Services.
Tapos may mga clippings ako. Dinala ko yun sa ICANN.
Pinakita niyo yung mga evidence
Use your mic.
Pinakita niyo mga evidence na...
Yeah, nasabi ko, wala pang internet, may intro voice now.
Yes.
Nakuha namin yung pangalan ulit. And dun, doon ko nalaman yung IP. Importante pala yung IP.
Yeah.
Okay, so you won that.
Yes.
Settled.
I won that.
It was actually settled.
Settled.
Yeah.
Okay na natin puntahan yun.
Okay.
Yun na lang. Yeah, kasi tumulong yung Octards about it na...
Yeah. So ngayon...
Shoutout kay boss ano.
Kailan pumasok si Eugene sa True Faith?
98.
After the settlement.
Yeah.
So after the settlement,
There was a change in lineup.
Change in lineup.
So parang
did you ang balita? You asked to join the band.
No, kasi magkabanda, may banda ako na before.
So pinirate mo yung kapatid mo.
Kabanda niya si Perf.
Perf before.
Kabanda niya si Chot.
Si Chot.
Oh.
Basis namin si Chot.
No. Basis mo namin si Chot.
Oh, there
Hoy! Oh, why, by the way!
No.
Belated happy birthday, Chot!
Hindi. Basis ng Rain Crowd si Chot. Singer pa siya nun.
Wait a minute. Yeah,
kami nila Perf muna. Pero hindi. Nung before ako sumali ng True Faith, wala na kami nila Perf noon. Kasi Perf joined
River Maya.
Yes.
Ang galing, no? Puro kayo Don Bosco, no?
Bosco yung si Chot, right?
Yes. Yeah. Kabatch ko. Kabatch namin ni Perf.
Okay. So, ikaw ang nagyayaki Eugene sumali ng True Faith.
Kasi they needed... Kasi ito ang nangyari. Nag-recording sila nung Looking Up album.
Okay.
With... ang drummer, si ano pa rin? Drummer, si Bimbo, June, and Med. Then they got si... No, then they got rin Yeng Remulla.
Yeng Remulla was the keyboardist.
And then
the drummer was si Jun Dizon, of course.
Si Jun pa rin.
Ang gitarista si Panis.
Ang gitarista si Carlos Dizon ng Hardware Syndrome ni Kiko.
Yes.
Si All Rock.
Yes. Pero kasi ang True Faith sanay na dalawa gitarista.
Yeah.
May lead na nag-electric. At saka kasi importante sa True Faith yung may acoustic folk sound. Yeah. Folk sound. Kasi
yun ang tunog eh.
Yun yung, parang...
Pautak ka, ang tunog proprietary. Kinuha mo yung kapatid mo. Di ba? Talagang, unless mag-away kayong dalawa.
Yun na nga eh. Akala niya, nung kinuha niya ako, mababawasan na yung away. Hindi, mas lalong dumami.
Nag-away kayong dalawa talaga?
Before, grabe ka.
Sino mas matanda sa inyong dalawa?
Siya.
So, binubully mo si Eugene?
Hindi.
Oh, he's the one who bullies.
I'm not the bully. You're the one who can't hold your drink.
Oh, lagi.
Yeah, exclusive. Hindi.
No. He bullies me. He bullies me and he physically...
Wait,
you know,
bullies you in a good way?
Well, you know what? Looking back, I think to be fair, you know, looking back, I think when he bullies me, protects me, yeah, from me and from whatever, from my vices, from my things. Yeah, pero paminsan is more like, you know, he bullies me for his advantage.
Dispute, Mr. Murphy.
I claim.
Grabe, taas ang rating nito.
I take the right to from self discrimination. Self discrimination to.
Pero anong kanta ang nagawa nyo together?
Wag na lang kaya.
So hindi kayo natuloy gumawa ng kanta?
Ayan ka na naman, bro.
Oh my God, I fell for that hook, line, and sinker, man. Sabi ko lang ame.
Paco, you've been doing that joke for 5 days now.
Paco, ilang taon mo
can
na?
You do, can you do? No.
How many years have you been planning that one?
Diba? Gene, have you been deaf these past 5 days? That's how he was doing it for the during the rehearsals.
Dude, pero
nag-JJ yun.
Ang galing. Ang ganda ng question ni Paco.
Cheers everybody. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. I love this show. Can we do a second one?
Sure.
Alam naman ni Paco na yun yung unang kantang ginawa namin dalawa ni Med. Pero tinanong niyo pa rin. Ano kanta ang ginawa niyo dalawa una?
Di ba?
Siyempre, wag na lang kaya.
So wag na. No, alam ni JJ, alam ni John.
No, alam ni Paco na we did that together. It's not the first. Come on.
No, he's been trying to set us up, you know?
Like ikaw, di ba? Ano kakantayin natin? Tutugin naman natin perfect. Alam ko naman na okay lang. Kung okay lang sa'yo, tutugtugin natin eh. Sasabihin ko kay Medwin. Medwin, ano to? Perfect? Perfect na ba tutugtugin natin? Kung okay lang sa'yo,
Huwag na lang kayo.
Sabi rin ni Paco, alam mo, kaya hindi tayo nakakatapos. Yeah. Eh. Kasi Med eh, dahil ikaw.
Dahil ikaw.
By the way, we're running out. Cheers.
No, we have beer. We have beer, man.
I can't mix.
So, nung ginawa niyo yung...
I love this show.
Thank you. Nung ginawa niyo yung wag na lang kaya, did he start with lyrics and melody or did you start with that tanonon? Chink.
Ito nga. Yung chord progression, alam niyo Mike Abad to. Kasi kinakanta namin simbahan yun eh. Yung we offer yung operatory song. Yun yung which is pero
pati yung ano pati yung hammer on
ako yung gumawa nun.
Okay.
Yung gumawa nun. Pero kasi yung chord progression nun parang yun.
Boys don't cry. Tapos, yun eh
sabi ni exactly
pero ka major 7
exactly yun nga yun eh
religious exactly. Song palang boys don't cry.
I know right.
Exactly kasi yun nga talaga.
Teka, it's a
familiar chord progression yung pataas na ganun tapos babalik sa pababa. So since yung narinig ni Med kasi membro kami ng choir. Yeah. Drummer ako ng choir noon, ha? Drummer ako ng
drummer.
Simbahan namin.
Okay.
Yeah, that was my first instrument in the drums. At tayo dyan. Inalasing tayo. may sasayaw na mga modelo. Yes, modelo, sumasayaw.
Thank you.
Okay, tapos, bayad, tapos. Bayad, modelo, bayad ha.
So choir, sa choir. Yeah. Tapos.
So, sabi ni Med, maganda yung chord progression niya.
Yeah. So hindi mo sinabi sa kanya, sa choir yan eh.
Hindi, alam niya kasi he was part of the choir as well.
Okay.
Diba, simbahan. Pero yun yung mga tumudugdug kami, di ba? Simbang gabi, yung madaling, Misa de Gallo.
Yeah.
Choir kami nun, darating kami nun, mga nasa. Dugdug kami. Anyway, gusto niyo yung chord progression. We should do a song with that chord progression.
Yeah.
Pero ginawa ko na yun, tadadang, tiyang, tiyang. Ginawa ko parang,
yes.
Is it samba? Ano bang, ano yun? Samba, no?
And yeah, parang ganun. Eh. Ganda yung ganda.
Oh, samba na, sa church, samba. Oh,
sa bagay. Ibang church yun!
Nasaan na si Glock na?
Tapos.
Ayun na nga. So, yun na nga. Naging hit. Gula. Ayun, hit na yun. Tapos, hindi ko makalimutan na nung nasa giraffe tayo.
What?
Giraffe. Yeah.
The bar. Yung hindi, sa ano?
Sa 6750.
Sa may ano.
Tapat ng Glorieta.
Glorieta. At yeah, saka, yeah. Ano yung hotel na yung Shangri-La?
Yes. Yeah. Suplado si Med, hindi umattend ng Awit Awards.
Oo.
Oh. Ah, di ba? Hindi umattend ng Awit Awards. Ang nag-attend nun si...
Suplado, I just wanted to party.
Okay, time out. Hindi, gusto ko malaman yung ano, bago tayo pumunta sa giraffe at sa pag...
Giraffe talaga. God. Such a fun bar though.
I know. Huwag dala kaya. Siyang magdala sa akin sa giraffe. Si Angel Aquino ang nagdala sa akin sa giraffe ng mga panahon yan.
Shout out
ang Gep.
Si giraffe, kasama ko si Elio at si, ano, si Kiko.
Oh yeah?
Kiko Magalona.
Yeah. So, nung ginawa mo yung lyrics, okay?
Nang
huwag na lang kaya. Did you guys know na you guys had a hit on your hand or again, walang expectation?
Wala ako nung recording. Wala ako
so, hindi mo alam yung lyrics?
Hindi, yeah. Hindi, alam ko, there you go. We were jamming it sa bahay. Diba?
Pero, was he singing the final lyrics nung sa bahay? Hindi.
Hindi ko alam kung may mga changes. Ano ba yung original? I can't remember the original one.
Pero nung ginajam niyo sa bahay, did you, Eugene, think na, okay, mukhang meron tayong in the bag dito.
Hindi, well, actually sa akin, wala lang. Eh. Kasi kami nila, perp, no, rock.
Yeah, yun ang nga minsan ganoon.
Ganoon, di ba?
Yeah.
So, I was like thinking, Hindi ko naisip na pwede namin itong gawing kanta nila perf.
Iconic yung ano, diba? Iconic yung paglaro nun.
Yeah. Diba? Lahat ng yata.
Lalo yung pito, right?
Yes.
Diba? If you're starting, kung nag-uumpisa ka lang mag-gitara, pag nagawa mo na yung tutudong, shit.
Meron ka na na buo.
And then, I'm good, man.
By the way, shout out kay JJ Buen Camino sa pito. Siya gumagawa ng pito.
Kaya, sa live.
Thank you, JJ, for doing last night, man.
Galing pumito yan.
Pumito?
Thank you, JJ. You're amazing.
Pumipito yan.
Hindi lang sa pito. You're amazing, man. Thank you. Thank you for backing us up.
Yan, paralo. So, when you made the lyrics, did you know you had a hit, Medwin?
I don't know. Parang that's sort of at the back of my head, I felt like it could be.
Because from perfect, time out. Perfect, wala kang alam, agnostic ka ron dahil there was no hit before that eh. Yeah. Pero ikaw na nga nagsabi, after perfect, sunod-sunod yung mga album, syempre may pressure. Yeah. Nung lumabas yung Wag Na Lang Kaya, feeling
the first, from the sidelines, from the sidelines. The first single from the Beyond Doubt album was Sa Puso Ko.
Yeah.
It was a minor hit.
Yeah. Yeah.
So parang nape-pressure sila. Naalala ko yun, nape-pressure kayo. Yeah, right. Parang, yeah. My God. Diba?
Okay na. Tapos,
gaano sila?
So, ganito. Was I conscious that it's gonna be hit? Parang at the back of my head, it might be. Because the lyrics are so straightforward.
Yes!
So simple.
But rock.
Yun ang ano dun eh. Kasi a lot of the songs that we make are really like very, very straightforward. Very simple. Very naked lyrics. Na you're not gonna decipher too much. You're not gonna
walang decoding dyan.
We're not gonna do some mind bending to understand the lyrics and the words. Parang it's there already on the table.
Correct.
So that's, I felt like it could be. And then when it happened, it happened. So it was like, it was amazing. Yeah, it was amazing. Kasi actually, hindi namin akala talaga na pwede. I mean, like I said, pwede, pero it couldn't be. But it happened. So, yeah,
correct.
Yeah. Just like with Perfect. Yeah.
So, okay. So now, yung mga collab nyo, yung incarnation ng True Faith, Eugene.
Yes.
So, ikaw ang wingman ng kapatid mo eh.
Am I?
You have to be. I mean...
I'm the goose to Maverick.
Yeah.
I'm gonna die.
Ayun
na.
Puchang galing na ako nun. Patok yun ah. Buti lang pelikula yon.
Yeah, buti lang.
Oh God, I just saw Top Gun recently. Such a bad movie. No, the old one.
Oh, the old one.
The old movie.
The new one. Oh my God.
I haven't seen the new movie, but the old was like really. I was like, what the fuck is this movie about?
Cliche.
80s cliche.
80s cliche. Sobra.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway, yeah.
So, Wingman.
Goose Maverick.
You know, okay. Ito pa, paano kayo po-position? Your brother is a star. Your brother is talent.
Yeah,
your brother...
Bro, starlet.
Starlet. Star. Okay. Star.
Ano kasi yung height?
Maliit.
No, kaya starlet. Starlet Express!
Umabot ka ba ng 5 feet?
Starlet Express!
Sino?
Bro, huwag mo nun.
Sino mas matakad sa inyo?
Bro, 5'1 naman ako, bro. 5'1.
Mas matakad ka sa asawa ko?
I think level kami ni Jan. Bro, 5'1 naman ako. Ano ba?
Pero Medwin... Oh. And kahit si Jonathan sasabihin to, you were very impressive. Agree? Yep. Very impressive nung OPM Summer Fest. And even kahit yung mga ibang shows natin.
Yeah!
Dahil sa iyo, bro.
Sa Soler.
Ah, well. Yeah. Did you have to... Did you put that in after... I'm still back in the glow of his praise.
We wanna go viral, man.
Yeah.
I'm still basking in the glow's praise, and then you put that in.
And I pulled
fuck
the rug
off.
And I pulled the rug under.
Fuck off!
Pero kakatoy sa niya. Doon muna sa. So, G.
Yeah. Thank
Star, you. Okay, Star. This is your commodity. Kumbaga parang sa intro voice, alam ko na si Jonathan, kailangan protektahan ko yan.
Yeah.
Kumbaga ganoon, di ba? Ako wingman yan eh. Pero kayong dalawa, magkapatid kayo.
Yeah.
how frustrating is it?
Here we go.
Right?
Here we go.
Kasi,
do the drum roll.
Meron kang isasuggest bilang babanata ka ng nakapatid mo na.
Well, we're talking about this, Jonathan, contemplate on how you are. While we're talking about this, Jonathan, contemplate about your relationship with Paco.
Ganun.
Ano li, bro?
Na, di ba, ito si Eugene. Kasi, pag kinukumpasan kami ni Eugene, alam ko na, okay, si Eugene na nag-iisip kung paano tatakbo itong mga kanta na to. So, nahuli ko na kagad yun eh. And, ay nakakatuwa, inisip ko, ano kaya ginagawa ng magkapatid na to na si Eugene may naiisip, itong na-visualize niya, tapos ipapresent niya sa kapatid niya, biglang sasabihin lang.
Galing na mga questions na ito.
Sasabihin lang ni Medwin.
Talo si Lolet Solis.
Shoutout kay Lolet Solis.
Grabe ka. Ibang intrigue mo, bro.
Uwi na to. Ayoko na.
Ang laki ng viewership mo neto na, bro. Pakiulit ang question. Huwag na lang kaya.
Kung okay lang sa'yo.
Alam mo, kaya tayo nagkakaganito ka dahil ikaw.
I don't know. However which way.
Don't worry, I will survive.
Tell me.
Sa lahat ng mga nanonood sa... Sa lahat ng mga nanonood sa...
Wait. Sabi mo, how will you survive?
I will survive.
Tell me. Tell me how.
Okay, guys. Nagkakalokohan na. Di na ako aasa pa na makukuha.
Thank you. Good night. Oh my God! Nina, what that was up? Can we go back to your question?
Ano tanong mo? Can we go back to your question?
Yes.
Huwag na lang kaya ulit.
Paco, you're killing me! Oh my God. All right, can I go
guys, pag nasagot ni Medwin itong tanong
when,
na to talaga.
So my question kay Eugene yung question.
Pag nasagot ni Eugene itong question na to, katawag dyan himala.
Kasalanan ba?
Oh my God, Andy, how can you stop this? No. Okay. Serious.
Okay, sinabi ko star. Sinabi ko yung kapatid mo is a star, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Patrick Star.
Pero paano Eugene, your frustration, magkapatid kayo eh. 'Di ba? So, ang filter ng magkapatid iba sa filter ng magkaibigan.
Yep.
Okay. Although kami ni Jonathan para kami magkapatid, so para pare-pareho tayo ng filter. Mm. Pero kayo, sa mga taong nanonood, how do you deal with it?
Hindi, pag sa live or sa recording?
No, bago, pre-production.
Sa recording kasi.
All things, right?
Kahit sa live concert.
Iba yung sa recording, iba yung sa live.
Pero minsan nasa, kasi singer yan eh. Mm. Minsan may mood yan, minsan, okay, parang, andali sa'yo para sabihin. Pero ako ang harap sa tao eh.
Yes.
Diba?
Yep.
Yun ang kanila eh. Yep. Diba? How do you deal with that? Sa mga wingman na nanonood.
Hindi, sa akin lang kasi, yung hierarchy. Mm. He's the boss.
Yeah.
You know your place.
Right.
I know my place. Di ba, katulad niya.
I know my place.
I know my place.
Nakipag para sa Canada, ang hiningi niya para ng talent fee sa inyo, beer.
Yep.
Okay, go.
We'll play for beer. Keep going. No. Yung hierarchy.
Yeah.
Seniority, hierarchy, una-una kuya. Diba? Yeah. So may hierarchy yan. Tapos sa music, di naman ako original True Faith.
Diba? Hanggang ngayon naiisip mo pa rin yun. Hindi ko ba naiisip na mas matagal ka na sa mga dating members ng True Faith?
Yeah, I mean, pero nauna siya.
Bago mo sagutin yan.
Bago, I mean, longevity, di ba? Parang...
Bago ko sagutin yan, commercial muna tayo.
Careful, careful.
Kailangan lagi maging
alam nyo, care. Alam nyo, kaboses ko na si Inday Badito.
Shout ilang out. Araw ka na lang.
Shout out, Dalian.
Okay, good, good.
Oh, okay, kaibigan natin, Dalian.
Oh, shout out, Dalian. Dalian.
Dalian.
Dalian.
Good friend. Yeah.
Promote mo tong show na to para yes. Maraming views.
So, oh, go, go, go.
Hindi, yun na. Hierarchy, yes. Seniority. We respect that. We respect that. So,
this episode is brought to you by Leo Bato and Associates, ang realtor na patok.
Yung sino yung unang dumating sa banda, like for example, kami dalawa ni Jake.
Yeah.
98 kami si Mali, and the others, sila Alan, Makin, Kaka.
After.
Pag ganun na yan, di ba? So, seniority lang. Minsan kasi, hindi ka naman pwede yung papasok ka sa banda. 98, pumasok ko.
Tapos mag-umando,
man. Tapos sasabi yung mamando ko, ito gusto kong tunog, ito ganyan. Hindi, you can't do that, man. Pero yun na nga, tas, as the years progressed, minsan may mag-ano na ako, magsasuggest na ako, ito gawin natin, ito gawin, lalo sa recording. Pag sinabi na, hindi, okay.
Seryoso, ganun? Okay lang.
Minsan. Balik na naman tayo dyan, hindi kayo matatapos.
Okay, okay.
No. Oh, tapos eventually, di ba, minsan, i-debate ko yung cause. Kasi yes. Minsan may...
Pag naniniwala ka sa gusto.
Oo. Okay. Minsan kasi, lagyan kaya natin ng ganito.
Right. Oh,
lagyan natin ng ganito. Tapos pag sinabi naman, hindi. Okay. Pero minsan, meron ako yung pag-uwi ko sa bahay, parang bagay ito. Gustong-gusto ko to.
Yeah.
Tapos sabihin ko kay Med, eto dapat yan. Eto dapat. Sa recording, this is recording. Eto dapat ang gawin natin.
Yeah.
Gawin natin. Tapos sabihin ni Med, hindi ko gusto eh. Okay. Kasi at the end of the day, siya pa rin ang kakanta.
Yun na nga.
Kung hindi niya feel yung kakantahin yeah. niya, yung areglo ng kakantahin niya, di ba, ma-o-off siya eh.
Yes.
Ma-o-off siya eh.
Yes.
So, at the end of the day, kailangan siya yun.
What say you? Mr. Marfil.
Yeah, of course, all of that he said is...
Kino-consider mo ba?
Yeah.
Or, palapit pala sa'yo si Eugene. Uh-oh.
You know what? My brother has a lot of wisdom.
I know.
He has a lot of wisdom in him.
Tooth. Teeth.
Hindi, yung music IQ niya malalim, ha? By the way. Malalim ang yeah. music IQ sorry, niya. Sorry. Which is, wala ka naman COVID, no? Wala.
I have allergies. So.
Okay, okay.
But, there's a lot of him that is really about wisdom.
Yeah.
There's a lot of them about him na insight. You know, I don't consider him like na parang he's younger.
Right.
Or he's just a bandmate or something.
Or he's just a troll.
You know, Paco, there are a lot of times na decisions we make are actually from his insights. Because
yeah.
I believe it's brilliant.
Yes.
I believe brilliant. They're very ideal. Sorry.
Water.
Sorry. Yes.
Cut.
Pick-up. Direct!
Hindi yan yung water. Yun yung water. Oh.
So, ganito. The good thing, yung ano namin, yung...
Dynamics.
Yung dynamic namin. He believes in me in the way I believe in him. You know what? I think he has so many... He has a bit of genius... na hindi wala ako. He has a grasp. He has a grasp of things that I don't have.
The guy has your back.
Yeah, he has a grasp of things that I don't have. And there was a time I didn't want to accept it. Na he was bright.
Right.
So there was a time when I was young and I was rebellious and I was I wanted to do things my way. I was like hard-headed and all that. You know what? My brother actually, he's younger and all that. There are a lot of times that his wisdom is actually more attuned to what is for the band.
And for you.
Yeah, for me as well. So, and the good thing about it, over the years, Eugene has actually learned to respect also na na what I want for the band is good. Right. So it's a balance of things. It's a balance of things. It's a give and take. So it's really amazing, you know. And the best, you know what, Paco, you guys, you know, Intervoice, you've been together for so many years.
So yeah, 36.
I bet you together right now, you feel like you're in the optimal stage of you being a band. You've had so many hits. Parang you don't need to prove yourselves anymore.
Parang masaya na lang. Enjoy
Hello,
na lang natin,
Paco, kaya. Jonathan, JJ. Parang wherever you go, you're gonna get an audience. I just learned that the Calgary producers just sold 2,000 tickets.
Yeah.
Come on! You don't need to prove that. You know?
Para paksa. Paks.
Yeah, let me finish first. We're gonna fight about this later. No, what I'm saying was just what I'm just saying, bro. Is parang at this stage of our lives, parang we've learned already what is right and what is wrong, and what to do and what not to do.
Yeah.
What to adjust and what not to adjust. What to expect from people.
Yes.
What not. Ito yung part ng buhay natin na
dapat
na,
yeah, low stress
yeah,
na yun.
Oh. Tsaka it shows. Dude, come on. You're doing shows and you making money.
Hindi, how about this?
Tayong lahat
doing shows, no ego.
Yeah, exactly. And we're doing it. And my brother and I are doing it.
Yeah.
We're actually so. I mean, I don't want to go into a new age thing or anything like that. But I'm attuned to new age things, Jonathan.
Go talk about.
Pero parang feeling ko, we are at the stage na we know things already.
Yeah.
And then we can claim it, and when we can do it, and you know, we can do it for ourselves, and then just
solid lang. Oh.
Solid lang talaga. And yeah. So, yeah.
Okay. Ang parang siya. Ayan, go ahead.
Yung Bax, ha? Ba't mo binabot sa akin? Bax, eto ha. Ngayon ko lang narinig na sinabi ni Medyon para sa akin. Yes! Ikaw na ang Oprah.
Oh my God! Pwede.
Papayaki mo ako, Willie. Willie tuloy, Willie.
Oprah naging Willie.
Si nanay, ano trabaho? Wala. Ang anak ko ilan? 5. Ano ginagawa nila? 9 years old. Ito, ang jacket.
ang parents niya, yeah.
Pero you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. Ang parents niya are still around.
Yeah, they're still alive.
Yep. Shout out sa nanay tatay.
Shout out.
Nagka-Facebook lang recently sa nanay. Dahil paalis kami.
So is,
kailangan niya mag-messenger.
Yeah, perfect sense. Perfect sense. Naintindihan din ni Eugene. It makes perfect sense. Yeah. Kumbaga wala nang time para
mag- As bands.
Kailangan mo i-mute?
As bands. Parang
wala nang time for bullshit eh.
We don't, yeah, no time for bullshit. Wala. We don't need to prove anything.
Hindi katulad dati.
There was so much pressure.
Yeah.
There was so much intrigues. There was so much
rivalry, may mga rivalry pa.
Rivalries. There was so much bad things coming on one way.
Yep.
And then you guys, well, come on. You're doing it already, and then you brought us into this stratosphere and
parang ganito, parang sinabi nga, shout out kay Maui Wawi. Sabi ni Maui na magiging president. Magiging president yung ginawa natin sa OPM Summerfest for other shows to do because it's a good template na parang
set the bar. Set the bar, man.
Pero ang sinabi ko kay Maui, ang magiging hurdle ng mga ibang promoters at producers na gagawa nito is the egos of these bands because tayo, we were courageous enough to set all of that aside and trust each other na walang madedehado, walang, di ba, kumbaga parang, yun ang magiging challenge. And I think after the first show na ginawa natin. Yeah. Seriously, kahit ako, sabi ko sa sarili ko, wow, sana magtiwala sa ating lahat, tayong lahat, parang ganun.
Yeah!
Galing, bro. Congratulations. Sobrang backstage, on stage,
rehearsals.
We felt the genuine.
It
was genuine. Everyone was so magnificent. Everyone was so transparent. Everyone was so honest. Yeah. Everyone was so fulfilling and
actually,
giving.
Transparent. Si Mark Mercado nga, di ba, yung transparency.
I think.
Yeah! Hey, hey!
I think it stems from you guys, yung producers, Jonathan, you, Paco,
ang vibe
na parang si Mark at saka ikaw, Jonathan at saka ikaw, Paco, alam nyo yung sentiments ng artists. Kaya as producers, you're perfect. Kaya nyo talagang i-imbibe yung whatever the artist needs. Come on, kaya thank you for the second tour, okay?
Yeah!
Second tour!
Yeah!
Definitely. Definitely. Galing, no?
We need to talk some more. Ano pa lang by the way, sinabi ko na before at different podcasts and sinabi ko na rin kay Barbie before, I just wanna say thank you sa dati yung manager si Tommy Tanchago. Kasi if not
para
for
sa kamera, Tommy, kung nanunod ka.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
No.
Kung Tommy, nakikinig ka. No. I just wanna say na toto, kasi ito talaga may video. Kasi yeah. I've said thank you to him in podcasts. Ito, Tommy, thank you na dun sa time sa Fullerton, naka-record kami.
Number one song.
Yes!
And dito may thank you. Yan. Tommy.
Ilan ang anak mo? Oh, saka na. Kamusta ka na?
Wait. Hindi na siya mata, pobre.
Okay.
Diyos ko.
Mga Gallaghers ng Oasis, magkaawa yan. Diba?
Ayan na. Ayan.
Oh my God.
Yay! Sandali, magpapadala ako modelo. Ito, modelo. Modelo, bayarin
hindi ba nahihirapan ng manager? Hindi ba nahihirapan si Andy, manager niyo sa inyo, to deal with your bullshit?
Andy, ikaw ka.
Ads.
Andy, kailangan.
Hey, Mike. Wala ka lang sa mic, Andy. No. Ngayon, hindi na. Ngayon, hindi na, di ba? Back in 2000.
Kasi sinabi ni Mark Mercado, magkahiwala na ang kwarto. Thank you, Mark. Thank you.
No, back then, di ba? Pumasok ko 98. 2000, siyempre, adjust, di ba? Kasama kasi, di ba? Kami sa bahay. Eh.
Yes.
Away talaga. Away talaga. Araw-araw mo nakita. Eh. Nakita mo sa bahay. Ano, mag-aaway talaga.
Hindi niya sinasabi. Ali, you know what? You're fired.
Oh, hindi. I resign. Okay. You can't fire me. Okay. I resign.
Okay pa pala yun, you know?
Oo. May mga ganun.
So, okay.
Eventually, kasi nga, tapos hihiluti ni nanay. Shout out, may Facebook na ang nanay namin. Finally!
Kasi ang pareho ng intro voice at saka True Faith. May dalawang Marfil, may dalawang Buen Camino.
Yeah. Letter S, Buen Caminos.
Buen Caminos, di ba?
Or Buen Caminay.
Buen Caminay, parang fungus fungi.
Ah, alumnus alumni.
Buen Camila. Ang witty, grabe.
Latin yan, Brad. Latin.
David Seldran, where are you?
So tatlong, okay.
Ang mani, hindi ko alam sa English, pero alam ko sa Latin.
Alam ko? Oh. Okay.
Sabi ni JJ, hello. Sabi ni JJ, lololololo.
Advice sa mga magkakapatid na gusto magbanda.
Yeah.
Together.
Mag-aaway talaga kayo.
Expected.
Sa umpisa.
Expected.
Pag nag-umpisa pa na, mag-aaway talaga.
Paano mawawala ang away?
Tanong natin yung Ben and Ben.
Tumanda lang kayo.
Hindi hindi naman nagsasalita yung dalawang yun.
Tumanda lang kayo. Tumanda lang kayo. Tumanda lang kayo. Kasi, yeah, wisdom.
Wisdom.
Is with age, di ba? Tumanda lang kayo. Tanggapin yun eh. Mag-aaway talaga kayo yan.
Pero, yeah, but how, if they're not...
I haven't killed you yet.
No. If they young, how do you? No,
you can't manage it. It happens talaga. Mag-aaway at mag-aaway ka. Magka-clash talaga kayo. Kasi yung sibling rivalry sa bahay pa lang. Especially kasi si Med is middle child. Gitna siya eh. Ako bunso.
I'm oppressed.
Ako bunso. Na may pakanay kami. Kilala ni may kabad yan. Batch 8. Puro kami dun boss ko Makati. Yeah. All boys. Batch 86, yung panganin namin siya, batch 88, tapos ako batch 91. Middle child to. Pag tinanong mo sa Don Bosco, pag sinabi mong Marfil, ang sasabihin niyan, either yung kuya ko, na salbahe, or ako.
Eto.
Hindi siya. Pero, nung nag-true fate, Medwin Marfil na. Siyempre,
right.
Alam na nila. He was quiet. Alam mo, sa aming tatlo, siya lang nakagraduate ng college. Kaming dalawa, nung panganay namin.
Grabe, daming information.
So, Mr. Middle Child.
Yes.
Are you happy?
Yeah, very much. Very much.
Parang alam mo may laman yung tanong mo.
Sabi ko na nga.
Are you inspired?
Perspired.
I'm perspired.
Pero
yes sir. Next question.
Kinakabahan.
Bigyan mo ng jacket.
Kinakabahan. Okay game. Medj, sa mga taong gusto mag frontman at kumanta, is there a difference between being a frontman and a singer?
Nah.
That's good. To be a singer, well, you have to be good at singing. You have to have your own voice. You have to have your own style and all that. To be a frontman, you have to learn how to connect. You know what I'm saying? And it's a challenge. Yeah.
The difference between the singer and the frontman. The singer is Pavarotti or opera singer. Frontman is Freddie Mercury.
There you go.
That's a brilliant
analogy, actually. Yeah, and there's no best frontman like
Freddie Mercury.
But there's a lot. There's a lot of fun. Yeah. Freddie Mercury, Simon, yeah. Steven Tyler of Aerosmith, Simon Le Bon.
Yeah, he's a frontman as well.
I take inspiration as well from a lot of R&B artists, a lot of I have great musicians. Prince, I like Prince.
Oh yeah.
So if there's a difference, yes. There's somebody who can sing, like Jed Madela can sing. But there's also
names style.
That's fine, yeah. I agree.
Good thing, yeah.
Pero can he be a frontman for a band?
You know what, for a rock band? Paco. There's a singer who can I'm thinking of Filipino na icon na magaling na frontman. And he doesn't even have a band. Martin.
Martin Rivera, yeah.
Yeah. He doesn't even have a band. But
he's a good frontman.
Oh, si Martin Gary, yung mga ganyan, yeah.
Yeah, I'm thinking more of like Martin. I think Martin can be like a good band leader.
He can connect.
Yes.
He can connect with
best thing about being a frontman is somebody who can connect with humor. With lots of craziness, yeah. You know, and Martin can do that. So I think Martin can be a good band singer.
So, tingin mo, nabot mo na yung ano mo?
Langit?
yung langit mo.
No. Ito na naman tayo. Here we go again.
Or muntik lang.
Ito na naman tayo.
Harap ng pucha talaga.
Paco, are you talking about this past week?
Ewan ko ha, ewan ko. Grabe.
No. What's the question?
Like, are you at your peak or sa tingin mo?
Ako personally,
this episode is brought to you by ABBA E-Services.
Physically, health-wise, I'm good kasi I'm feeling very good.
Good.
I want to promote as
go.
That's my advocacy.
Flaxseed ka na naman.
Ano nga, okay. Totoo yun. Advocacy kasi is veganism and being going plant-based is really, it has been really good for me. Paco, plant-based, I swear to God.
Okay.
I swear to God. I swear to the higher power. Going plant-based is really good for me and it's doing wonders for me. And so that's amazing.
So vegetarian? No.
Vegan.
Wow, yeah. A vegan.
So not
vegetarian.
Oh. A vegan guy.
Oh, vegetarian.
Vegetarian.
A vegan guy.
Hindi ako vegetarian. Vegetarian.
I know you're having a lot of it.
Go, just one.
Wow. Oh, dito ka muna. Upo ka muna.
Oy, go.
Dude, the podcast is right over here.
I know. I got lost.
We have a bubble here. You're not supposed to go over there.
I know.
Okay, vegetarian.
I got lost.
Vegan.
Okay. So, Ilocano
siya. Taga vegan.
Teka, mukha may disagreement kayong dalawa.
No.
Pero sinusupport mo yung veganism niya?
No? He doesn't have to fuck.
Ako? He said the F word again. We should take a shot every time he says the F word. Asan ang tequila?
Pucha, malalasing tayo. No, pero okay.
Everybody should take a shot.
Ang tanong ko, ikaw ba? Sinusuporta mo siya sa pagiging vegan?
Yeah, okay naman yung sabi niya eh.
Pero ba't hindi ka vegan?
Ang sarap ng lechon. Diba?
Ikaw ba nagagalit ka sa kanya pag nagle-lechon siya?
Of course not.
To each his own.
When you say that, that's a band na I don't stop them. Nung si Andy was our manager sa banda, I don't stop them. Parang it's
how long have you been vegan?
6 years. I'm sorry. Why are you clapping that?
Kasi yung sabihin, marami ka na na-save na cow. Yeah.
Yes, chicken. Of course. Moo. Hindi, pero ano, yung sila Andy, sila no. I don't stop them kasi it's still a personal choice.
Yeah, okay. Tama yun. It's an advocacy. Ako kasi, semi-vegetarian ako. Kumakain din ako ng baboy, ng ano, takagulay minsan.
Same.
Makain din ako ng baboy.
Eugene. Okay, seryoso.
Yeah, there you go.
Is True Fate going to be your last band?
Yeah. The band?
Promise.
Medwin, ikaw.
Careful. No. I'm doing some stuff as well.
Right.
Kasi when I got the amp, may nakuha ko mga gadget. I'm doing some stuff na parang side project.
So, maganda gawa niya.
So, nag-loop ka ng mga MPC.
Side project. Oh, I'm doing some side projects. Pero, kaya nga. Kasi, ano si Med. So,
mag-solo ka?
Hindi. Ano sabi mo? Mag-ano si Med?
Oh, mag-jayo. Ano'y ganoon? Ano'y...
It's a small...
So, mag-migrate...
Hindi ko pwede kantahin.
Ka na sa Amerika. Ganun ba yan? Bali? Paano pag nag-migrate
yung... I wanna be a scriptwriter.
Yun, paano pag nag-migrate yung kapatid mo sa Amerika? Is it game over?
No, I'm still gonna be in music.
As True Faith?
No, not True Faith.
Wala
my
na.
Own.
Garayan na.
Kasi, bro.
Here's the thing. true faith is Medwin Marfil. Ang boses ni Med. Magpalit-palit ka ng lineup, magpalit ka. Pinasok mo si Jay Valencia. Jay Valencia, ang Tak Andres ng Pilipinas. Shout out Jay Valencia kung nanonood ka.
He was there last night. Yeah. He was there last night.
Kenneth Ilagan, shout out din sa'yo. Tapos sila ka. Sino pa ba?
Sina Alan.
Si Carlo. Si Panis. Si Panis! Panis, di ba? Ang dami. Dami nagpalit ng lineup. Pero, ang tunog talaga ng True Faith is yung acoustic and Med Marfil. Medwin Marfil, the voice. The voice talaga. Pansin mo, kahit yung mga ibang songs namin na mahilig kasi kami mag-experimenta ng ibang...
Nga, yeah.
Yeah, we like to experiment with different genres. Like for example, yung... When was Bliss? Yung Bliss album namin.
1998.
That was 98?
1998.
Oh yeah, when I joined. 98. Kinuha namin si Brian Kua. Shout out kay DJ yeah. Brian Kua. Anyways. To do a dance. Medyo may pagka...
Dance album, yeah.
Medyo may pagka house album. With True Faith flavor. True Faith pa rin eh. Pag pinakinig mo. True Faith to eh. Makikita, marinig mo. Boom. Four in the floor. Jug, 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 jug. Pagpasok ng boses ni Med. True Faith to. Because... True Faith is Medwin Marfil. Diba? Mm. Ah! Wala ba palakpakan dyan? Yeah!
Ladies and gentlemen, True Faith. Wala ka na pwede sabihin pagkatapos nun eh. Totoo na yun, yun na yun eh.
Kaya? Better than virtual. Better than virtual. Buti na lang, Mike. Hindi natin tinuloy yung virtual.